Hello friends, today we will discuss some interesting fact of coaxial transmission line. Coaxial lines are unbalanced transmission line because the coaxial line having inner conductor and outer conductor, and the impedance of inner conductor is different from the outer conductor. The principal mode of propagation in the coaxial transmission line is transverse electromagnetic mode. In the transverse electromagnetic mode, the electric field and magnetic field both are transverse, and there is no electric and magnetic component in the direction of the wave propagation. The field pattern and cutoff frequencies of these modes are obtained by solving the Maxwell's equation. The radiation losses are minimum. The noise pickup is less. So these two are the advantages of coaxial transmission line, and this is because the coaxial lines are shielded and they are covered with a jacket. Higher order modes also propagate in the coaxial transmission line. At low frequency, there is no cutoff frequency of a coaxial transmission line, but the energy can also propagate in other way in coaxial line, and that is called the higher order modes. These higher modes are transverse electric mode and transverse magnetic mode. These higher order mode can propagate only when frequency exceed from a certain value, and this is called the cutoff frequency of that mode. Similarly, higher order modes exist in a coaxial line if the wavelength is close to the physical dimension of the line. It is very important content. The lowest wavelength that will propagate is called the cutoff wavelength. So cutoff wavelength and cutoff frequency both are similar terms. Cutoff is refers to the highest frequency tested by the manufacturer, or when the frequency reaches a point where the coaxial cable become a waveguide. Hence, a coaxial cable upper cutoff frequency could be where the coaxial cable remain within a specification, or when a reasonable margin to avoid the transverse electric mode or transverse magnetic mode. It means if a high frequency propagate through a coaxial line above the cutoff frequency, that time the transverse electromagnetic mode will no longer, and the transverse electric mode or transverse magnetic mode will travel, and the coaxial cable will behave like a waveguide. The higher orders are expressed in the term of transverse electric mode or transverse magnetic mode, and the lowest order mode are transverse electric 1-1 mode and transverse magnetic 0-1 mode. If you want to know that why transverse electric 1-1 or why transverse magnetic 0-1 are the lowest mode, then you have to go through the mathematical derivation of all. Transverse electromagnetic mode is non-dispersive mode, and the mode is traveled with a velocity independent of frequency. It means the velocity of the modes in a coaxial transmission line does not depend on the frequencies. We can use the coaxial transmission line up to 100 gigahertz frequency, and the small size coaxial line can handle the more power, and they can also interface with the waveguide. We can send a signal of 18 gigahertz over poor old RG6 coaxial cable and a loss only 57 dB per 100 feet. We can also use coaxial lines in the cell towers, usually LMR 600 cables, which can easily handle the LTE frequency about 2 gigahertz at only 3.9 dB of loss per 100 feet. DOCSIS, satellite, LNB, MoCA, and Wi-Fi can make use of coaxial cable despite being thousands of megahertz. So we can use coaxial transmission line up to 100 gigahertz, but there is some constraint of the constraint on the use of coaxial transmission line, and these are the skin depth and cutoff frequency. So what is the meaning of skin depth? In a conductor wire, the charges are penetrate into the conductor wire and moving along the conductor. But at high frequencies, the charges cannot penetrate the surface of the conductor, or they penetrate very small amount of the surface. So all the charges will coincide over the only surface part of the conductor, and rest of the conductor portion will remain empty. And this is only used for the mechanical strength of the conductor. So that is called the skin effect. And up to this limit, the charges penetrate to the conductor is called the skin depth. So the skin effect leads to increase the attenuation and dielectric heating and causes greater resistive loss along the coaxial line. That is why at high frequency, there is some limitation on the use of coaxial transmission line. The another limitation is the cutoff frequency, and a cutoff frequency is the point at which energy flowing through the EM system begins to be reduced by attenuation or reflected rather than passing through the line. It means if we are using coaxial transmission line for propagation of transverse electromagnetic mode, then there is no problem. But at higher frequency, when transverse electric mode and transverse magnetic modes are generated, that time they are not passing through the line, they are the transverse electric mode will be reflected back. So because of these two regions, there is some limitation on the use of coaxial transmission line at high frequencies. Thank you.